measures. Get down here. What are you doing? Do you want to break your legs?
My fault, sir. It was a soft landing.
What have you got there?
Special cargo. For victims of the flood.
All right, proceed. But no tricks.
Yes, sir. Last container. No worries.
Me? I wasn't worried. It's just that the last time we sent it on the train, half of it was stolen. Where is the captain? Where?
There he is.
No need to shout, madam. Nothing will happen to your boxes.
First of all, I'm not madam to you, and these aren't boxes. It's humanitarian cargo for victims of the flood and toys for the orphanage. We collected it from the whole region.
What is it?
It's not ours.
It's ours.
Attention. Hello, madam.
What's this?
This has nothing to do with you. A good customer is having a party. His daughter is getting married.
Wait, we've got humanitarian cargo. I've spent a lot of time getting all the paperwork here.
Not raise your voice at me.
I'm sorry.
I promise to deliver your stuff, and thank I will. You should be thanking me.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
General, sir, we'll be overweight with the SUVs.
It will be within the limits. Listen up. Tomorrow we need to be at the house of the newlyweds with these cars. Shining like boots on parade, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, can you deliver this, please? There's a boy in the orphanage, Daniel. He's waiting for it. Okay, the man who's meeting you knows. Will you deliver it?
Okay, sure.
Thank you so much.
Here.
I'm in charge. We need to drop the cargo or we will crash.
I'll drop the charity stuff. The hell with it!
People need this cargo.
Children! Drop it! They can collect more! That is an order!
Why are you looking at me? Do it!
You have the plane.
I have the plane.
What is your name?
McCoy.
Hurry up! I will write you a reference. In a difficult situation, Pilot McCoy did not hesitate.
Did that just happen? Or was it vodka?
Tell me, why do you care so much?
I don't care.
McCoy, don't forget to return your key for the room.
So what? Makes no difference. Better to be rational, you understand? There are rules. They ask you to turn, turn. They ask you to close your eyes, close them. People will do their own business and then they'll help you.
Tell with such rules.
And where does that get you? All the money we could have been paid. Now you can't even fly a crop duster. You're blacklisted.
You trying to make me feel worse? Cheers.
Look, you're a great pilot. You can't live without flying. You'd die. I know you.
Everything's fine.
Why are you so stubborn? Go and speak with your father. Ask him to help you. Having your father, how did you manage to be in such a hole? Well, let's hope he helps you.
I'll say it again, I won't ask him.
Why? Because of pride?
He won't help. He's not gonna like this.
What will you do?
I haven't decided.
Alex. I know they wanted to fire me too. Thank you for taking over.
Forget it.
Please go to Moscow. Talk to your father.
No.
Listen to me.
There is no point in continuing this conversation.
You do realize you just killed my career.
I didn't. I wrote a report that mentions you cannot work as a pilot for our airline.
I'm not competent to work in your company. You're the one who has it all figured out here. This one doesn't
fit. I'm sorry.
This one either. Are you the only pilot here? None of your trainees become pilots.
Sorry.
Perhaps this is because of you.
Perhaps it is. Perhaps I should be the one to not allow unbalanced and unattentive people to fly planes. And this is what I do. Goodbye.
The problem is, they're all bad and have no skills.
Hello.
Why are you late?
Sorry, I got lost.
Are you going to say that to the passengers?
Where's your paperwork?
Why is your CV so bad?
Okay, get into the simulator. Standard takeoff, weather is good.
Gears up. Flaps, position.
That was good.
Michael, add some clouds and moderate turbulence.
Approaching the desired altitude.
You should take echelon 160.
It will be better there. Did you hear me?
I hear you. I prefer my way.
He's flying over.
Nice.
Michael, please. Let's add a bit more. And right engine.
Firing the engine. Coming in for landing. At the nearest airport.
Michael.
-5°C, runway 18. Tailwind.
Leonard. That's too much.
Brake. 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 The runway's too short. Brake.
Thank you.
So what? He touched down. I look at the facts.
A military pilot crashed the plane. Anything else?
He was doing great. You failed him on purpose because you hate it when someone does things differently.
Kesha, as always, not here. Pilot Grandes.
Yep.
Pilot Bedford.
Yes.
Pilot Saunders.
Here.
Pilot Peterson.
Yep.
Peterson on the ropes.
There are rules. There are instructions and procedures. And his references couldn't be worse. So don't protect him.
I'm not protecting anyone. In no circumstances, even you wouldn't have landed the plane.
No one would.
Okay. Hold this. Start the same simulation.
Why are you kicking it?
Is it yours?
I don't think so. Still look like it.
What idiot parked it like this?
I don't know.
A woman would never park a car like this. Must be one of the pilots. What was he thinking?
Give me the keys.
Why?
We'll try to fly over it. Keys.
Are you a pilot?
Here. You.
Keys?
I'm Alex.
Sandra.
Sandra? Can you give me a lift to the station?
You need to sign the exam protocol.
What are you thinking about, Mr. Pilot?
Ex-pilot. Ex-pilot. I failed the test today, actually.
Are you a bad student?
On the contrary, I wanted to show the instructor what I'm capable of, and he failed me.
You need to be smarter.
What do you mean? What do you do, by the way?
I don't do crazy things.
The flying is crazy for you.
Arguing with the instructor is crazy.
Aim for your confidence.
What's more important for you? Flying or your ego?
What does my ego have to do with this?
This is what I like about men. What do I have to do with it? Everyone is to blame but yourself. Pick up the phone, will you?
Why are you saying this? You wouldn't understand.
I wouldn't understand. As if only you understand everything.
Who?
You.
Quiet.
What?
Please be quiet. Yes? What? I will.
Get out of the car.
Yes.
This doesn't mean anything. It will all depend on your performance. You are not a pilot yet. You are a trainee. You are still on trial. You will obey my instructions and working directives. After each flight, I will make a report on how you have performed. But note, I see everything. And if something goes wrong, you're out. Clear?
Thank you. Thank you, sir. And I'm sorry for not taking the right echelon.
Make sure you have the passenger and cargo report on my desk by 9 a.m. Is that clear?
Yes, okay.
How are you?
Good.
Hello.
Leo, 124.
124 what?
124 airports. I'll catch up with you soon.
You count well. Good job. I'll ask them to transfer you to accounting. McCoy,
yep.
Get the paperwork.
Yes, sir.
They've given me a trainee again. I'd rather fly alone.
Munich.
Wow. Hi.
Hello. You look at me as if I'm here by mistake.
Where are you flying to?
Amsterdam.
I'm flying to Munich.
Congratulations.
We'll be back at the same time. This is my first flight. Celebration afterwards. Do you know the restaurant Crane? Crane.
Thanks. I'd prefer Amsterdam.
Is she a pilot too?
Who?
The girl you're talking to. Sandra.
Are you here to work or what?
My fault.
McCoy!
Good morning,
please,
sir.
Meet our new second pilot, trainee McCoy.
Hi, girls.
Hello.
Oh, sorry, man. I didn't see you there.
Yeah, I'm very hard to see. So, how about a climbing wall, Vicky?
What?
Let's go together. It'll be fun.
Andrew, I'm having enough fun without a climbing wall. I'm Victoria.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. I'm the head of the stewards. If you need anything, please come to me.
Got it.
Andrew, so where are you're not a pilot.
I don't want to be.
Vicky's only nice to pilots.
I can live with that.
Always good to know.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is your captain speaking. My name is Leo Fitzgerald. On behalf of the crew, I welcome you on board our plane, flying from Moscow to Munich. The flight time will be 2 hours and 55 minutes. I wish you a pleasant flight.
Flight 117 is ready for takeoff.
Flight 117, you're cleared for takeoff. Runway 19.
You have the plane. Let's take off. No stunts, please. Throttle is at max. 100 knots.
Check.
Takeoff speed.
Woohoo! Whoa. Landing gear up.
Gear up.
We are finally home.
Is everything okay? The passengers are worried.
Everything is good. Sweetheart, can you get me some coffee? No sugar, please.
McCoy.
First military operation?
This is not a military flight. It's a civil airline. And inside you have passengers, not Marines with parachutes. 200 souls that just want to get home. Is that clear?
It was my fault. I pulled up too fast, but nobody died.
Don't even joke like that. Now listen to me carefully. Today I will not file a report on your incorrect takeoff, but this is the first and the last time. And I will not tolerate rudeness towards members of the crew.
What are you talking about?
How you spoke to Andrew. He is your colleague.
It was a joke. I always thought it was more of a woman's job.
Up in the sky, every job is a man's job. Do you have a wife and kids?
Who? Yes. No.
A kamikaze. You don't care about yourself, and you'll end up killing your passengers. So, McCoy, you have been warned.
Can I congratulate you?
Yes.
These are for you.
Thank you.
So they got upset, turned their backs on each other, and then Sylvia from the second department comes in and says, I just saw something. What? Did you say something? Did you say something?
No.
You don't like it? I can give you a cutlet. What happened?
They gave me a difficult trainee.
Oh my God. Again? A difficult trainee? You should spend more time with your son. You have a family, you know.
We have a normal family. Husband works, wife works. The son is an idiot.
He is not an idiot. He just doesn't see you much. I don't see you that much.
Quiet.
What's wrong?
Quiet.
What happened? Stanley, have you gone mad? Do you realise that this is a third floor?
It's fine.
What's fine?
How many times do I have to tell you there is a door in the house? Stop climbing through the windows. What if you fall? Who will put you back together? What is this?
What?
Is it new? Are you getting ready for the prison?
Huh?
Maybe you should also start drinking.
I don't drink or smoke. I'm Mr. Clean.
Who?
Nice of you to ask.
How is your Spanish?
We're getting on pretty well.
Stop talking to me like that. When are your exams? They must be coming up.
Don't know yet.
Well, who does?
I'm not going to be
a lawyer.
Oh,
come on. Let me put you into flight school.
So what, then I can become like you?
Wait.
Why, like a taxi driver?
What?
Oh. Can I go to sleep now?
Sleep, that's good idea.
How can you speak to him?
Can I go to sleep?
Stanley, I forbid you to close the door.
Try?
Stanley, did you hear me?
Stop pounding on it. Stop it.
I hear you.
I forbid you to close the door.
I want
to. Did you hear me?
If you have someone in your company
Stanley,
who knows Spanish well, maybe you
can. Are you even listening to me?
He needs help.
Do not shut the door on me.
Good night, son.
Ah, Laura.
Hello, Mr. Fitzgerald.
You got a minute? McCoy, wait. Listen, Laura. There's someone I know who desperately needs help in learning Spanish.
You mean tutoring?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'd love to, but I don't tutor.
Laura, it's important.
Is he your relative?
Well, it's my son, actually. The school taught the language poorly, and he didn't pass the exam. Look, he's talented in general, but idle, and you're trustworthy. Please help. Just don't give him any leniency. Will you come tonight?
Mr. Fitzgerald, you know I'm busy. I rarely see my husband.
Thank you. Please. Well, you know, I'd be very grateful.
Come on.
So, we're agreed.
As always.
Well, let's go.
Stow away your tray tables.
Vicky, what are you doing on Sunday?
Andrew, if we are talking about me spending time with you, then I will be busy.
Landing gear down.
Flaps, landing position.
Going away for another round. Landing gear up.
Gear up.
Flaps position one.
Speed is good. Position one. Flight 117 going for another approach. Give me control. I have the plane.
You have the plane.
Are you crazy?
Do you know what you're doing?
Sorry. Weird.
Leo, the whole tower's going crazy.
Yeah, bad fog.
Yeah, but if it wasn't for you...
Yes, it could have gone wrong. Almost fired that trainee.
The captain of the other plane took completely the wrong echelon. He directed his plane to the same runway you were headed. I don't know how you saw it in the fog.
So what?
What do you mean? A Turkish Boeing? If you didn't react as fast as you did and didn't turn around for a second approach, I can't even begin to imagine what could have happened.
Hi.
Hi.
I must say this trainee...
Quiet.
What is going on?
I'm studying with this new tutor.
Good. Okay.
Do you want something to eat?
I will tell you, this trainee surprised us all today.
Diez y siete.
Just wait. It can break you. You have to work even harder just to be treated equally. Otherwise, you get trampled on. If before the flight, I announce, "Dear passengers, this is second pilot Sandra Coleman," then the passengers start yelling. A woman behind the controls? Do you know how tough that is?
We're talking to each other like two pilots, not two lovers.
First of all, you're not a pilot yet. You're a trainee.
I don't think it's a good idea I come over anymore. Is he Stanley?
He's a good boy. Don't worry about being strict with him, okay?
Your coffee.
Thank you.
Strong.
Thank you.
Black, no sugar.
Vicky, get back inside the plane.
Andrew, does our second pilot seem a bit strange today?
Vicky, get inside the plane, please. Go inside.
What's going on here?
This is a revolution, Vicky.
How long will they keep us here?
Quiet, this is the tower. They're checking all the passengers. They'll only allow foreigners to leave. The locals will remain here.
Why?
Such are the rules. Proceed. Just be careful out there.
please. Okay.
Where's my husband?
Okay, where's your husband?
Jeffrey.
Sit down, please.
What happens to the others?
We can't take them.
Why not?
Read out the control card.
Wait, let's try to do something. Sir, we can contact the consulate.
Read it out. These are foreign citizens. We are not allowed to interfere. This is their business.
Your rules are rubbish.
Alex.
Where's your corkscrew?
Look.
People die, but we still have to follow the rules.
Yes. This is exactly what a girl wants to hear.
Sandra, what's that have to do with it? Do you know what happened?
What?
We were in Africa. There were refugees. We could have taken them on board.
I know about
it. But we weren't allowed. So why are you acting like this?
I'm just interested. Why do all men start crying in difficult situations? Why didn't you just stop the plane? What was the problem?
Sandra, let's not get into it.
What? You're so brave, but only in the kitchen, huh?
Are you crazy?
Don't yell at me.
Sandra, no one is yelling.
Don't yell at me.
Do you want to fight?
That's it. Not a single word more. Hello, taxi?
Sandra.
Can you send a car? Number 2, Roseby Road, first entrance. The passenger will be waiting downstairs. Thank you.
You're not a pilot. You're just a woman behind the controls.
Hello.
You think that I fly a lot. I don't.
Have you finished with your glasses?
When are we going to take off?
Soon.
You think that I fly a lot. I don't. My granddaughter organised it.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Don't fly a lot.
Have a lovely flight.
Can I get a pillow?
Sir?
Thank you.
Would you like anything?
No.
Oh. Finally. Flight 117, all passengers are on board. We are ready to take off.
Sir, your seats are here, please.
Go on, there.
Fasten your seatbelt and have a good flight.
Excuse me, can I have some cognac?
We can't serve it now as we're about to leave. I'll bring it as soon as we take off.
Do you know who this is? Do you read the papers? Do you watch TV?
Don't play around.
1 minute. Sir, that passenger is demanding cognac.
Well, give it to him. Let him choke.
Trim up.
At 30%.
Controls?
Check.
Well, Should we try?
Your cognac? Fine.
Good.
Please put out your cigarette. It's prohibited to smoke on board during the flight.
What will you do? Maybe get out?
Please put out your cigarette. You are violating rules on board.
What rules? What are you saying?
Relax, sit down.
Get out of here.
Sit down, please.
Don't touch him.
Sir, we have an emergency. They've hit Angie.
It's fine,
don't
believe me.
Don't interfere.
It's fine, believe me.
Fine,
don't call me.
Stay in your seat. The pilot is not allowed to leave the cabin.
One second.
It might be provocation, or they could be taking the plane.
JD McCoy.
Please put out your cigarette.
Who the heck are you?
I'm the second pilot.
So go and fly. Mind your own business. And pay attention.
What the hell?
Sit down.
You can still explore.
Yes, now.
This is flight 117. We have an emergency. Coming back to the terminal. Well, I have to say, this trainee was a disaster. What? Is he studying?
Wavey? Dios? Once? Dose? Come on, you can do more.
I can't do any more.
I told you he's been a little devil. I knew he was up to something. Can you see he's mad?
The door should have been locked.
You said it yourself. Don't lock the door.
Get away from the bar. Do you know what you're doing? Do you realize she has a husband in my team? Do you know how this is going to make me
look?
What
kind of husband is he? He's never at home, like you.
What?
What are you thinking? What does he think? What did you tell him?
Nothing.
Darling.
I said nothing.
Commander, or what? How did you let this kid out of the cabin? The video's all over the internet. A fight on an airplane. I'm just back from headquarters. There is a big attack on our airline. We might not make it. I need to fire you.
Well, fire me.
What? Can you repeat that?
I will not say that I am sorry. In fact, I envy this kid. I was taught to stay quiet, to keep my mouth shut. Whatever the problem, put up with it. It says no here and underlined here. We are afraid of everything. We hide behind
the instructions.
Do you
think you're the only one?
We don't even know who made them
up. Every day, my day is the same, and I'd live with it.
And he doesn't, because he is the right man.
First, you need to teach him some manners. He has to behave himself and respect authority. One of our planes is being charted privately. It flies today. We change the crew. You are the pilot. The job is for a month, minimum. It'll give us some breathing space. You will need to take two experienced second pilots. You may choose them as you like. And we are firing this kid. That's it.
No, we're not.
Come again?
We're not firing him.
Is he your son or something?
No, he's not. He's a great pilot. We have hands, you and me. He has wings. He does things in the air that I'm not capable of. So thank you, but I'm not flying without him. That is my decision. Let him be beside me.
What about exams? They will kick him out of college.
He will take them when he returns. I want to spend more time with him. It will be good for the both of us.
You can't do that. What if there's a fire or something? I left half of his things at home. I forgot to pack his socks.
I will buy everything there.
Okay, but don't forget to.
Why are you so dressed up?
What?
Why so dressed up?
Me? Why? I always go to work like this.
Always?
Every day. Why?
Get down from there.
Did you hear what I said? What's the point of taking him away for a month? He needs to study. I could keep an eye on him.
Hi.
This is nonsense. Stanley, stop.
Behave yourself.
Son, a kiss.
Okay, let's say goodbye.
Bye.
And darling, don't forget to return your security pass.
Socks?
Goodbye.
Bye.
McCoy, please meet our second pilot. We'll be flying together for the next 4 weeks.
Sir.
We'll talk later. First shift, Coleman. McCoy, you're next. Let's prepare for takeoff.
Hello.
Hello.
Can I stay here?
You can't stay in the cockpit. Go inside the cabin. Take the bag. Carefully. And flight attendants are off limits.
Okay.
Captain?
Yes.
Did you request me on purpose?
Yes. They say you have a light hand. Sandra, prepare for takeoff.
Don't gain weight because you're constantly stressed.
Mm-hmm.
You fly all the time, you're constantly burning calories. Because you were sitting, walking, I'm being serious with you. If you lived at home now, it'd be a different matter, you know?
Yeah.
Seriously.
Alex. Captain's calling you.
Do you know Kamwu? It's a volcanic island to the north of here. They just reported an earthquake, and there is a possibility of aftershocks. They're asking for help to evacuate the wounded. We are the closest to it, and we have no passengers. The airline is saying it's at our own discretion.
Let's go.
This is 117, changing course to Kanwu.
Flight 117, we will not be able to get you permission.
You will.
Let me take the pilot seat.
Negative. The airport there is on a rock. The approach is incredibly difficult.
So?
Sandra is a more experienced pilot.
Wait, please. I need to give you a shot.
Get off me.
Captain.
Hello.
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 Good that you made it. Very good. You will take our specialists, women and children. There are some wounded. Buses will arrive with people any moment now. You need to take everyone. Everyone.
Will the locals fly too?
There are no locals here. Only people that come to work here on the factories.
Is this so much in pain?
Yeah.
Will you take us?
Sure, we'll take you.
When?
We need to refuel and then we'll fly.
I don't have a passport.
Now we'll take you without a passport.
Can we fly?
Will you take the bodies as well?
What bodies?
The dead. There's a lot of them. An awful lot.
Let's deal with the ones that are alive first. What's the forecast?
I don't know. I really don't know.
Well, who does know?
Listen to me. The volcano is the problem. We have to fly out of here now. Can't you see?
Look, calm down. The buses will arrive, and then you can fly. They'll be here soon.
Well, where are they? Do you know anything?
Stop. Don't shout at him. He's in shock. His wife just died. Peter, I have to do it. This is to calm you down.
I'm going to the tower.
Come back quickly. Sandra. Go to the medics. Find out what's happening there.
Yes, sir. Zeke, please. Come here. Come here, Luna. I'm not going to go
on a different plane. This way, over here. Over here, this way. Come on.
I'm begging you. My husband hurt his back. We must fly. Can you help get him on the plane? He can't sit or stand. His back is broken. We have a small target. We must get him forward.
Our plane needs to get out of... No, we don't. I've been here for hours. One plane left, another plane left. And yet, look at me. I'm still here.
Okay, sir. Please. Okay, Danny. Right back.
On ne t'inquiète pas, regarde, je suis avec toi. Respire, tout va bien, tout ira bien.
Come on!
Get to the plane!
Don't panic! Please do not panic!
Everybody quiet! Don't be afraid! Everything will be fine!
From this spot. Okay, we're getting out of here.
You can't. The main runway's damaged. There's a crack in it and a section is missing. We can't take off. We need to call for help, but it'll be morning before we hear anything.
What's over there? Behind the water tower?
Over there, there's another runway. But it's completely engulfed in flames. Can you see the main fuel tanks are there? They're on fire. They could explode. Well, once the fire's burnt out, we could try to use it, but a plane that heavy can't take off on a runway that short. It won't get enough speed. It's impossible. Ah, here are the buses.
Here, here! Over here!
Stanley!
Be quiet! Sir, don't worry. Step away from the plane. You'll be able to take everyone. Please don't panic. Step away from the plane.
Maybe we try to extinguish the fire on the second runway. We could try to use the water tower.
What's the point? There's not enough runway. We'll end up in the sea.
So what do we do?
I don't know yet.
Where do
what?
We go? Where
what
do we
are
go?
You talking about?
Tell me. Tell me, please. Where?
Stan.
Where do I have to go?
Go that way.
Tell me something.
Run to the plane.
Go back to the plane.
But it's your responsibility.
Who is in charge here? Are you in charge?
No.
Where is the captain?
There he is.
Captain, sir, stop. My name is Marguerite.
James,
we must drive back. My sister
James,
and kids are there. There are more people there.
Where are they?
One more bus is still in the mountains.
I told her to come with me, but she's just so stubborn. I told her to come with me. She
Calm
has
down.
Some kids. She's just an idiot.
Captain, when can we start boarding?
Wait, we can't do it yet.
I don't know what to do with them. I'm asking the drivers to go back, but they won't. There's been a landslide.
Can we take this minibus?
Well, we can try, but there's about 30 people there. They won't all fit into one vehicle.
What should we do? I'm going.
No, you're not.
Sir, we can't fly yet anyway. I'll be quick.
You're a pilot. Your job is the plane. Stay here.
And leave them like we did in Africa? Let's go, let's leave them here. What are we here for anyway? I'll be quick.
Wait, I'll show you the way.
I've got it.
Stay here, stay safe. They'll manage without you. This is not a job for a child.
I'm not seven if you haven't noticed.
Captain! Captain, allow me to go with him. He won't be able to take everyone.
Andrew,
please
watch my kid.
Okay. Above the factory.
What's going on?
Don't worry, it'll be fine.
What's going on?
As long as there are no more quakes.
What is it? What's going on?
Well, it must be fine because the lights are back on.
It's incredible.
Runway is damaged. All flights are cancelled.
Calm down. Please.
Somebody tell us what's happening.
Let's go. We're leaving.
John, no. I won't leave without him.
Come on, let's
go.
No,
John. I'm not leaving without Maxwell.
Then hold this.
John, what are you doing? Come back.
Let's go.
I can't leave my sister's here. Wait. What's going on?
Liv, calm down.
I'm still trying to get hold of my sister.
Helen, where is John?
He walked to that plane, Sean.
How, Helen?
Do you know
how?
How plane? It's going to take off. I don't know.
Stanley, get out of there!
I'm here!
Mom, is he alive?
It's okay.
Get people to the car. We need to evacuate.
What should I do?
We'll
be evacuated shortly. Let's get organized. Follow me. Everyone keep moving.
I'm here!
Are you hurt?
No.
Crawl here. Give me a hand. Push with your leg. Again, it will work.
Cargo plane. Is it operational?
It should be.
Where are the pilots?
Dead. All dead. The whole crew.
It has a short takeoff distance. There's a chance that we could make it.
But what if we can't?
don't have a choice. We need to get out of here.
You're not going to put these passengers in the cargo bay, are you?
I am. Ready the passengers. We're waiting for the buses. And then we take off.
We need to go back!
Go back where? The airport's ahead of us!
Quiet!
Where are they supposed to drive on?
There's nothing there. They're not coming back.
If we're not in the air in 5 minutes, there won't be a runway. There'll be nothing left.
Everyone, get on board.
Go. Go. Go on. That's it. To the plane, go. Go.
Is the plane refueled?
That's it.
If you're alive, McCoy will make it. Go inside the plane.
Come inside the plane.
Okay. Give me a moment.
Flaps down. Let's go.
Everything will be okay.
Breathe deeper. Good.
It will be fine.
Hold it like this.
Everything. I'm afraid of that.
Really? And I'm afraid of flying.
We should get them well.
Like, miss, stay calm.
Just keep putting pressure.
This is a critical moment. Sir, there's not enough runway.
Take off.
Who's the captain? Are you the captain?
Yes! What are we gonna do?
We'll figure this out. We're asking you, how are we gonna take off?
We'll take off using the second runway at the end of the field. Get on board, hurry up, and let everyone on.
Okay, let's go up the stairs. Everything will be fine, remain calm, please. Watch your step, please hurry. Up the stairs, quick, let's go, come on. Let the kid through. Go up the stairs, please. Everything's gonna be okay.
There
you go, watch your step. Please board the plane.
Sit down.
Where's my mom?
Don't worry, she's on the other plane. Put your seatbelt on.
Please sit down. No. Sit down. No. Sit down. We stop, Captain. What's the delay?
There's burning fuel on the runway.
So what do we do?
Do you see that tower? There's water in there. The fire. We'll push the tower and it will collapse and put out fuel on the runway. We'll have a few seconds to take off.
And what if it doesn't collapse?
Enough. We'll discuss that after we land. Go back to the cabin. They need you there.
Thank you.
fine. Sit down, please sit down.
McCoy!
Relax, everything's fine. Sit with me, getting boring without you. Come on, come on, don't be afraid.
Fire in the left engine.
Everything's under control. Keep the passengers calm.
How?
Gently. You're the man for the job.
The plane is going through a volcanic ash. There's fire in the engine because...
How soon will they clear the ash cloud?
We don't know. There's a possibility of fire in the second engine.
Is there a landing strip nearby?
What landing strip? There's only ocean.
It worked. Fire's out.
But the engine's not working.
Fire in the second engine. Decreasing speed. Trying to put out the flames. Sir, please close the blinds.
Thanks for coming.
Who is the pilot?
A trainee. We recently hired him.
I'm not engaging the extinguishers or the engine will stall.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
I'm clear of the ash cloud. Fire's out. Stanley. Go to the cabin, see what's going on there.
Excuse me. Are you going to serve food? You know, there's hungry people here.
There's a strong vibration in the engines. They're clogged with ash, and there is a problem with the landing gear.
Ready the nearest airport.
Peter, we need to ready the nearest airport. They won't manage to fly further. Ready the nearest airport. That is their only chance.
New information. Switch to second channel.
The fuel tank was damaged during takeoff. It's leaking. I'm losing fuel. It's not enough to fly to the mainland. I repeat, fuel tank.
Captain Fitzgerald.
Is that you, sir?
Trainee.
Trainee McCoy.
McCoy, you're alive.
Yes. How are you? Are you okay? How's Sandra?
She is fine. Where's Stanley?
Here, put these on. Put them on.
Stanley, can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
I would never have abandoned you.
Stanley?
Stanley?
Can you hear me?
Sir, sorry, it's me.
I got it, trainee. Alive.
Grow up. Are you 5 years old? He waited for us till the very end. He refueled our plane. Stop whining.
We're losing fuel. Here's the plan. I'll try and land on water. You will call the ships and pick up everyone that survives.
They don't have other options.
You could have the whole Navy out there, but landing a cargo plane on water in such conditions is suicide.
Leo, how much fuel do you have left?
I have about 20 minutes, if I'm lucky.
Can you make it to land?
So, what procedures do we have for this?
There are no procedures for this.
I once saw on TV, there was this guy that climbed from one plane to another in midair.
sir.
I have an idea. As one of my relatives says, crazy idea.
Crazy? That's something we need right now.
We drop to a minimum altitude, to 10,000 feet. Is it possible?
Yes.
Can you hold a minimum speed of 350 knots, no more?
Yes.
Pressure will be close to normal. I'll open the door. I'll come in from your tail. And you will open the cargo bay. And we will transfer the passengers on a wire to my plane.
Is it possible at all?
Theoretically, yes. But no one has ever tried it.
It's suicide. We need to call the emergency services. Maybe they have something to recommend.
This is real life, not a circus. There's too many people.
Don't you understand? They don't have a choice.
The planes will collide.
The wind's too strong. They won't be able to stay stable.
117, I'm not allowing you to risk it. You'll have one engine. You'll be lucky to land your own plane. I prohibit it. You'll be locked up if you don't comply.
We need to land first. Stanley, we're not a military flight with parachutes for everyone. We have 200 souls. About 200. Attention, please. This is Pilot Alex McCoy.
Our plane is on its way to the mainland. Soon you will all be safe. But there is another plane near us. It's damaged and has people on board. They won't make it if we don't help them. We'll need to take a risk and try to transfer them to our plane. I can't make this decision on my own. I need your support.
Unanimously. All those in favor? Why are you still sitting there? Go, count.
They can't risk it. 60 instructions. How will we look each other in the eye after this?
Well, that's easy for you to say. You've never been in their situation.
Are you sure?
And who will answer for this?
Let's not interfere then.
Keep calm, I see it. Okay, guys. You two go and get ready. Open the door. Just be careful there. Stanley?
Huh?
I need you to work together, right?
I'm gonna go and help.
Can I I come with you?
No, you're in charge here.
Is my mum on that plane?
Fasten your seatbelt.
Push!
Together, push!
That's it. Go on, then. Here we go. One more time. Push!
One more time.
Everyone together now. Everyone together.
Again.
Push! It won't open.
Captain, I can't open it. I'm sorry. Sorry.
Alex, listen to me.
Dad, is that you?
It's me. Who else could it be? Who else? Listen carefully. I have an idea.
What idea?
As always, a crazy idea. Lift the floor in the compartment.
The instructions say we can't go in there while the plane is in the air. There's avionics and navigation systems there.
I wrote those instructions, but those were for normal situations, and you are far from normal there.
Lift that floor in the compartment.
Try opening the cargo hatch. It opens up, so it should work.
And if it doesn't work, just
kick it out. It's all there. You can lift the passengers through that hatch.
I don't know if it'll work.
We'll make it work.
Hold the lower echelon and hold the distance. Got it?
Got it.
Get down and hold on! Hey. Hold on! Kick it up free!
Hey!
Dad. Thank you.
Three!
Mom!
It's fine. Sit down.
Okay, it's okay. We're gonna get you safe.
Attention, passengers. My name is Sandra Coleman. I am your second pilot. We will now board the second plane in the air. Check your bags and cases. Put on any warm clothes that you have. If you have creams or gels, put them on your faces and hands. If we panic, we will all die.
Everything will be fine, don't worry.
If we stay calm,
please stay
we will live.
Like this. I will give you my daughter's phone number. Please, can you make sure that you call her for me? Will you? Please.
Come on,
really
don't panic.
To me that
you will call her yourself.
I'm not getting in there. I'm staying, sorry. Her name is Sophie. Please, I haven't seen her in 7 years.
My sister was on that bus with her 2 children. With 2 kids. I told her to go with me. But she wouldn't listen. We argued.
I see.
And the last words I told her was that she was an idiot. I hate myself for that. Oh, I said one of the lines wrong.
Move back. Carefully, move back.
Yeah.
Opening the hatch. Move back.
I need to get even closer to the cable. I'm gonna have to turn the plane.
Use the rudder, but carefully.
Got it. Using the rudder. The altitude and speed. I'll watch the distance.
Master.
Come here. What's
okay, honey,
doing?
You go first. You go first. I'm right behind you, all right? I'm right behind you.
Leave our song.
They're newlyweds. She won't go without him.
It's too heavy. I need some help.
Guys, everyone help, please.
Come on. Push.
Quickly, carefully.
Push.
Captain Fitzgerald.
The first party's on board. You're doing great.
Attention passengers. Does anyone have any spare warm clothes? We need to get them to the other plane so they can transfer the rest of the people safely.
Here. Please, take this. Please.
Thank you.
Keep it.
Here, take my coat. Take mine.
Fuel is on the limit. Losing altitude.
Hold them.
Owen! Owen!
Get your hand off. Help. Keep it under your head, yes? Yes? Sit down. Are you okay?
Could be worse.
He's gone. He's gone. He's gone.
Let's swap places.
You better go back to your son.
He's not my son, actually. He's the neighbor's kid. When the earthquake hit, his mother died. I don't know how to tell him.
Directly into a storm.
Can you do this any faster?
Captain, we're sending the last party.
Go with them.
No, I won't leave you.
Go, I said.
Quickly. Go, please go. Vicky, hold on. Hold on.
Quick, Sandra, get on. Go, get on.
Hold on tight. Hold on.
Pilot now!
Tie it on! We'll go together!
Tell her to fly lower!
Thank you.
Is the captain on board?
Slowly, slowly, slowly. That's it.
You were awesome.
Lab is the clean?
Almost.
Andrew.
Don't worry, I'm okay.
He said that Mum was on the other plane.
Trying to help you.
Uh-huh.
Go to the compartment, I'll help you. Come on, get up.
It's okay. Go, thank you.
Captain, I wanted to say that I was a bit harsh back there on the island.
A bit?
Captain of Flight 117, Leo Fitzgerald. The crew and the passengers are on board.
Leo, take control.
Second pilot McCoy will fly the plane.
Okay. 117, we're planning to land you at the nearest airport, but we've received a storm warning. It's now closed. There's a storm there and the clouds are very low. The wind is very strong. Can you make it to the other airport?
Our engine's at its limits. It's full of ash. The second engine is out. We won't get through the storm. We'll be landing at the nearest airport. Prepare the runway.
Sandra, leave us for a minute.
Get out!
Dude, she's more experienced. I didn't train for this.
Neither did I, and nor did she.
Sir!
I'm scared. There are so many people on board. I'm trying not to think about it, but I can't help it. I've already done everything I can. I can't do it! My hands are shaking. I'm very scared.
I'm scared too. Even more scared than you are. You at least can hold the controls. I can't do that. This plane is extremely reliable. Others would have fallen apart in such conditions. Like in the simulator. Remember, it's almost the same now. You can do it. Maintain balance until the end, when you touch down. Decrease speed until the wing touches the ground.
It'll get ripped off!
That's it. We'll discuss this when we landed.
117, I'm diverting you to Petropavlovsk. Good luck. Well, it's with God now.
Vicky, time to make the announcement. Try to stay calm. I can do it if you want me to.
Yeah, I'll do it. Attention passengers. We are getting ready for landing. Please follow our instructions. Store your trays away. Stay calm.
What are you doing?
You must sit, please.
And make sure that all luggage is underneath you. Gentlemen.
Don't be afraid. It's scarier in the mines.
Return your headrest to the upright position. And make sure that all luggage...
The lights have gone out. We're coming in. Get ready for emergency landing. Put the headrest up, please.
The emergency exits are located on the left and right side of the cabin. Stay calm and listen to instruction.
Okay, Hero, can you hear me? Let's play. When we touch down, hold your arms and legs like this. Got it?
Everything will be okay.
No, just no, I don't want to leave. I don't want to leave.
Stay calm.
I don't want to leave my sister.
Please sit down. Secure the overhead lockers and make sure all luggage is underneath you. Listen, it's okay.
Please help us.
It's all okay. Stay calm. Please. It's okay. Sit down. Stay calm. It's fine. Sit down.
Deploy, Fats.
Fats, position 3.
Speed check. Position 3. Hold the place steady. Control tower. Get fire trucks and ambulances to the runway.
See the runway. I can't see it!
Use the navigator.
I'm fine by navigation.
Critical altitude.
I can't see the runway!
Thrust engaged. Hold steady until the wing touches down. Hold it, hold it.
Hold the plate.
Hold it. Not the softest landing.
Not the softest.
You passed.
Did you land? Tell me, did you land? What about the passengers?
We landed.
Talking about me spending time with you, then I'm free. Alex?
One moment, Sandra, one moment.
Everything's okay.
What's with the hand?
It's fine. I thought, what if we go on holiday? Somewhere with a bit of sun. Together.
Yeah.
Pilot Johnston.
Here.
Pilot Crocker.
Here.
Pilot Shepherd.
Here.
Pilot Martin.
Here.
Pilot Coleman.
We haven't got a chance.
Pilot Coleman. Oh, Pilot McCoy.
Here.
Trainee McCoy.
Here.
Trainee Fitzgerald.
I'm here.
To the ropes. Trainee Fitzgerald.
Now I'll be embarrassed.
Go on, get up there.
Trainee Fitzgerald, come on.